traveling offshore can open up an entirely new world of boating experiences.
This not only includes the activities that you can do offshore, but also the hazards you may encounter. Preparing for an offshore adventure can take a significant amount of time and planning. There are potential hazards offshore that need to be considered before launching. Let's discuss how you can prepare and things you can do to be safe while operating offshore. This will include developing a float plan, looking at the forecasted weather, and following your pre-launch checklist to include supplies and safety and emergency equipment. Also, a self-assessment of the fitness and health of the boat operator and passengers is important to consider before launching. Are there medications that need to be taken at certain times, or physical limitations that would limit a boat operator's fitness for an offshore excursion?
There are many considerations to take before making the decision to head offshore. Let's take a look at what information is in a float plan. Float plans should include the time and location you plan to depart, a description of your vessel, length, color, registration number, how many passengers you have aboard your vessel, details of where you are traveling, how long it will take to get there, the time and location you will return, communication equipment you will have, cell phone number, VHF digital selective calling equipped radio, supplies and emergency equipment you will have. There are apps you can use to download a digital float plan. This information needs to be shared with someone who can notify first responders in the event you do not return as planned. Make sure you contact this person before you depart and when you return. If you're unable to reach this person during your scheduled communication times, they'll have all the information they need for the first responders to find you. Getting caught in a storm is a common boating hazard, and one you can often prevent. Using accurate forecasted weather and real-time weather information will help you plan your trip. There are various information sources available. However, the National Weather Service, NWS, is always a source that can be trusted. They broadcast constantly on a VHF FM radio, or you can get them on the web. You can find forecasted wind and wave information, visibility, and live data of on-scene wind and wave conditions from buoys placed along the coastline. NWS also publishes forecasted weather warnings, like small craft advisories and high surf advisories. These are notifications of wind speeds and wave heights that have reached a specific level, creating more hazardous conditions. Use a pre-launch checklist, which can be downloaded, to conduct a full inspection of your boat anytime you take it out. You'll want at least two communication devices, such as a cell phone and a VHF FM radio. The further you get from shore, the less likely it is you will have a cell signal. VHF FM radios allow you to communicate with any and all boaters on the water in range of your broadcast. And VHF FM radios with digital selective calling, DSC, hooked up to your GPS can send an automatic SOS along with your GPS position. Inspect spaces and the function of equipment. Using this checklist will ensure you don't miss anything on your inspection each time you get underway. Some things on your pre-launch checklist should be the inspection of bilge areas for water and engine fluids, electronic equipment like navigation lights, marine radio, GPS chart plotter, radar, and depth sounder, and engineering equipment like steering and throttle control, engines, installed fire extinguishers, and bilge pumps. Having basic tools and a few spare parts, belts, light bulbs, etc., on board is a good idea. The more you use the pre-launch checklist, the more complete it will become, as you learn more about your boat and add items of importance. Two distinct pieces of safety equipment you should focus on when boating offshore are personal locator beacons, PLB, and the type of life jackets each passenger will wear. Attaching the beacon to your belt or life jacket can save your life should you become separated from your boat. And wearing the proper life jacket for offshore use is very important. PLBs are battery-powered devices that send out a distress signal. The signal is sent out via satellites and earth stations and is coded to the registration of a person. These devices are small enough to attach to a person and have a very high success rate of rescue when maintained and operated correctly. The U.S. Coast Guard can also locate your boat if you've taken the precaution of having an EPIRB device. The Emergency Position Indicating Radio Beacon will alert the U.S. Coast Guard to the location of your boat. Having a locator beacon for your boat and on your person offers overall protection should you become distressed or separated from your vessel.
Consider the type of life jackets you have available to you. You must be honest about your in-water comfort. Are you able to tread water for an extended amount of time? The U.S. Coast Guard goal is no greater than a 2-hour response time. Although inflatable life jackets are comfortable and more popular to wear, it is a good idea to have an inherently buoyant, non-inflatable life jacket available for backup when traveling offshore. The inflatable life jackets have an air-holding chamber, which, if punctured, would become useless. Using inherently buoyant life jackets marked for offshore use provides greater flotation, turning, and stability in the water while rescuers make their way to your location. Following all of your preparations, you get underway and head out onto offshore waters. Because you have planned your trip well and thoroughly inspected your boat and equipment, you are feeling confident. Always remain alert to the environment you are in and the function of your boat and equipment. We have learned how to properly prepare for traveling offshore, to include equipment and inspection, weather, and the importance of a float plan. Learning how to prepare for an offshore trip and things you can do to be safe are just a few topics in learning about boating safety. Challenge yourself to learn more and share this knowledge to make everyone safer on the water. Education is one key to remaining safe while boating.